Vanuatu last. And we've got three aggressive captains.
bad. And the guys coming off a good win this, in the first game, the Mighty Afare Panthers, and there'll be a lot of info scoring, they're just waiting for that to come on. National team?
Yes. She is, so poor girl's probably out for one. The streaming cutting in. Moving at each game, so.
Team free, coronavirus fee, and that's why we are able to play.
There's one there between Laz and
Selwyn. Since Might and Power come down the come down the freight and one
shape a bit there and swung very.
We guess
Laz won't draw back. The moment got to him. Two.
You really swung.
Give yourself a chance, and that's coming in the bat. I don't know, Jim, Redback Jim's all over him, and he won a.
Yeah, true. Just a short, short.
Backlift and whippy. Short arm jab, and he's got that for a nice fall. And I'll be... Jamal, both like the ball coming on. They've gone to. I think that's why, mate. I think that's why. That's it. We call it. Sorry. Yourself in the shed
with the lap shots and little sweepy shots and
a little bit. He definitely doesn't like spin early on the Jamex. So I think we've got
But the way everyone round, and it's to Makia. Pace on the ball. So he's just gone back and he's just dotted that. And then it was quite a silly shot. Yeah,
the power play.
The pressure builds again.
and save him. That is...
If he was in a partnership, that would have been a great shot. Looking quite fit at the moment.
Yeah, he's Ken Bolley. Heavy
cricket shots to the Sharks. And Wes, Vince Vero showed that maybe they obviously did it last year. They were in the final last year, so. Well. Puts it in front of point just for an. Yeah, we've got seven off the over, and I've got them at.
Because that mate, get through this ASAP. Someone gathers it. He's got some good left arm spinners. I'll be.
Strike.
On this.
To backward a point, and he's very.
He likes to think he is.
Without.
Lots or nothing going on in his mind. I'm not having worked it out yet. Go there unless she bowls stump to stump.
Yeah, he's bowled quite well. Always a good thing to do. And the body language by the team out there just under the. warm up. They've come.
Well, it's just not good enough if they want to take out this title. Bulls versus... And then we go back to the... Well, no, it won't be, and they'll be looking forward to
oh, shame!
Voila! Compared with the other teams.
Kaffir Bulls, and I have this to say.
Partners, Bet Barter.
Bat again.
He's tossed it up.
That's Carlo. They're not.
He's got a bit.
Bouncing above his waist.
I need to slip in. I need.
It's slow. Also, if you. Guys, if everyone plays. First, oh, he's literally tripped as his bike's on out there. It is a greasy. Dude, well, mate, have we got. Who uses the bowling both ball and.
Well, I need to. Innings.
Though. Cricket awareness.
Whoa. Bit of music happening. Alive. They didn't hear him out. They didn't hear him before.
More subdued in the run. Now this back in a few weeks to play. And okay, they got... there. Is that Michael Abbott?
There. Not gonna misfield that. Oh, he's let the.
Watch what. Just tried to play the big shot.
But that's.
It's come with 3 for 11 off. Use his feet, being the wicketkeeper, he will pick it out.
Kindly to there could be a
big difference. Allen goes back, hits the point. And just get him over the line here. There's no need to go and smack it around, but.
Balls, they will get you.
Back on the ring, they need to move in and they're.
Big future for those two if they can stay in the game.
place if we can. If we can. Plays yeah. Forward a little bit.
The Vince Ruiz, only 16. What a...
out on the boundary.
That's the stumps.
Fine leg there is stretching. Team, haven't they? They're thinking about the risk.
Yeah, I would have unleashed a big Apo Stephen and tried to blast a couple of wickets of bowling full and straight and hard. But
can bowl a bit of in swing, and with this. I was old, and put a chance in their arc to hit him to the leg side.
Definitely. It's just cert. You can nip it away. We could take him balls, leg, LBW and bowled.
Yeah, I feel that boundary of the last four last over really cost them. They need. Will take wickets. Offside field.
We've got to rush this.
Inside the circle. Allah and just there, we would imagine he would be, because that's what he does. Bolt upright.
Sorry, Damo, I was just. Simpson,
nice
that's four. That's probably the game. He's come out and done the job. But they just didn't look Didn't look up for it. Didn't look all.
Back of the hand, he's dragged.
Sorry, Rach.
Hello, Stevens. The chatter from here, and now they've Do you throw a slip in? Do you throw a short mid wicket in, a short cover, catching cover? You need to do something. Appo in from the Bellevue end.
Oh, he's flicked.
He's tried. Well, if you're going to try it, now's the time. It's a caught and bowled. Simpson Obed has tried to do a standing up lap shot. That's what it looked like.
He's tried to flick it over.
Looks like
he's
hit the toe of the bat, skied up, and it's been an easy catch for Appo.
If he's going to go take a risk, I would go mid wicket. But he'd played that shot, even though it was a spinner before. That's must be one to go. Then here comes McMillan Makia, I would say, who had a little cameo in the last game, played pretty well, must have got a 15 or a 20.
We're ended at 6 over. I didn't think it would go 6 overs. We're 4 for 28 off 6 overs. And it just shows the strength of the Fair Sharks bowling lineup. And the spinners, they've got a lot of options. And they've got a lot more bowlers, which we haven't seen today. The captain, Nalin Nipicho, hasn't bowled yet. Razu hasn't bowled yet, but he was in the first. He's in the batting team.
No, they've got Obed Yusuf, Stefan Sandy. Vince Vera, Leggy, they've got Nalin Nipicho and Appo Stephen. That's five quality bowlers. And you've got Avok can roll his arm over as well.
Yeah, I've missed the wide. We've got one delivery to go. You had a wide in on the third delivery there.
There's some hot chips just got delivered to the commentary box as well required. There's McMillan.
There we show where the field's just not quite right. He's just pushed it through into the covers and has got an easy single, which is quite silly when you're defending that total.
Yeah.
That takes him through to 29 at the end of the six overs, 4 for 29.
There's a lot to think about for the Sharks overnight, I think. They've got it. So they'll have the first game against the Melee Taffia Bulls. Both teams needing a win. Melee, besides Andrew's innings, didn't have a great outing either. Andrew sort of stole the show.
He stole the show. He's a superstar this afternoon. Patrick Mataltava, out first ball, caught on the boundary, hitting into the wind, missed it a little bit. He'll be keen to get back out there.
Yeah, so definitely a lot to play for in that first match on Saturday.
Vera coming in to bowl again from the Lagoon end.
A couple of hits away from winning, I would have thought, Damo.
Two hits.
Two hits away.
We need 7 to win.
We played the Mighty Saints week before and got away with the first game back here, and he's done it again.
There's a lot of bottom hand in that.
It's a shovel. You can't call anything else, but it's not a sweep.
It's the shark shovel.
It's not a sweep. It's, I don't know. It's only a shovel. There's no front elbow. But hey, he got him over the line last game. I reckon he got the Panthers to that 120 odd, which when Wes got out, I didn't think they were going to get to that many.
Yeah, which they needed in the end. But Vince Ferry's pushed another one through here. He's beaten Jared Allen again. Very handy, Vince Ferry here. Comes in again. Jared Allen uses his feet just a little bit, gets it on the full toss, hits it in front of cover, and he gets a single there.
I don't see why the inner ring are all back on a 30-yard circle.
You can't give him a single.
You've got to close him in and try to make him hit over the top and try to get a catch, as he's just done. Abbo's under it, and he's spilled it.
That's a great effort. Great effort to get there. He's moved a fair way. I'll get back for two. Abbo, he made long. He did well to get there. He never probably looked like he was going to catch it, but he did well to get there.
He got there easy in the end, though, didn't he?
He did get there easy, yeah. Probably surprised himself. Didn't time the dive that well. Love's a big diver. Love's a big skid into the boundary.
Yeah, I'll tell you a story about that soon as Vince comes in. Oh, it's a stumping. He dropped it. He had it in his glove, and then I don't know what he tried to do with it. Tried to take it too easy.
I think Vince Rear just showed his bowl quite well. They're flat again. The wicket keeper just wasn't up to the job this time. A bit like your stumping that you missed a little while ago, Shane.
Tough job, mate.
And again, Vince Vera's beaten the batter. He's beaten the keeper again.
He's bowled well.
Finished off with two dots.
He's bowled well.
Four after that over, and they're still there. 34 for 33 at the end of the seventh. And who thought it would go into the seven overs? That's how strong their bowling lineup is.
Oh, that's what ordered these hot chips before. I thought it'd be eating them by now, but I thought the game's over. Now they're getting cold. I don't get the runs, Damo. Get hungry.
It's... And the captain, Nipigo, is going to bring himself in the bowl here.
Yeah, it's been
another good bowl. I like him with the new ball because he does swing the ball. Can swing it both ways.
Does swing it both ways.
Swing it a long way both ways, but not much left to work here with three runs needed. Three overs to go, three runs needed.
Yeah, the first game was a great, great game. Lots of great hitting. Second game probably hasn't lived up to the level of the first game. All the big guns probably got out early, which doesn't help.
Yeah, once Nipigo got out, he was their real key there.
Yeah.
Once he got out, the score went from 100 and something down to 80 score. Once he lost another couple of wickets, the score just kept going down, didn't it?
Yeah, national players, a lot of overseas pros, they've got to carry the team with bat and ball to a certain degree. So you're going to give that out.
Yeah. And he's gone to Yorker straight up.
I didn't think he hit it. Oh. I thought it was out for me. Did you hit it?
I'm calling bat, and Jared Allen's looking at his bat on the way off. He's having a very good look at his bat. So he's not happy with that decision, but it's a wicket LBW.
Oh, I don't know.
A wicket LBW in the book, and that's what we're doing. That's what we're calling it. And it looks like Selwyn is coming out.
I'll tell you what, they've made a very hard work of this 36 target.
Well, we're 5 for 33. After they scored 128 in the first game earlier today.
They had a real chance to get that run rate up. Net run rate up for the competition standings. You could have polished yourself quickly and, yeah, been a real two wins with a great net run rate. In a six-game competition, that's going to put you right up there. One or two more wins, four wins, you're going to be in the final, I'm sure.
Yeah, Nipigo did exactly that. He can bowl it to death, can hit a good Yorker, can swing it both ways, will bowl your bouncer. So you would think he's just going to keep going Yorker, Yorker. You miss, he hits.
Oh. Anything can happen. I played a fifth grade game at Bankstown. It was a tie. We needed four wickets and we got to go double hat trick. It was a tie. So anything's possible, mate. So this game wants to. I'm not calling it yet.
A real effort ball there by Nicky. I could hear it through the mics there. And we've got a leg by there, so he's going wicket to wicket. Captain Nipigo, he's not gonna walk off yet. He wants to go all the way until they hit the final run. Mark, you're on strike here. Mark is gonna cross bat it. Nipigo is gonna go Yorker, he's gonna go up the stumps. I think we're going to see a bit more timber knocked over here.
I think there's a chance. I think Patrick knocked him over the first game. It was a no ball with a big Yorker. So, yeah, I don't think you need any fielders on the offside as Nipigo comes in the bowl. He's gone to that leg side, favoured leg side. Yeah, what? Can you have nine on the leg side? So, with the Marky McMillan shovel, mate, there's a few drops of rain coming here. I can feel it. So, you've got to hurry and get these runs. Because I don't want to turn on the Duckworth Lewis computer.
There's only two.
Because the computer's eating chips at the moment.
They're making two to. They're needing two, mate. There's not that much to go, but they're making hard work of it. We're in the middle of the eighth over.
The Panthers on the sidelines ready to come in and take the win.
There's
one.
Just gets a two full and he.
They're clapping. That must be it, I think, mate. They needed one to win. They had all the fielders on the boundary. Surely not. Well, I've seen it all now.
Oh, I think manager Mark Dunn needs to have a talk to their captain. There's a lot of missed cricket happening.
Yeah, and Simon Keane too, because that's Vanuatu's national captain, but he's new to that captaincy.
Yep.
It'd only be his third match he's ever captained.
Yep.
So, obviously a bit of work to do for Nalan if you go. But anyway, mate, another win for the mighty Whare Panthers. So
they've done it well today, haven't they?
That's a great day one for them. They'll be taking that any day of the week.
Yeah, they did the first one with the bat. They did the second one with the ball. They'll be back here Saturday again trying to get a third win in a row at the Bet Barter Vanuatu Blast.
It's been a great day. Public holiday here in Vanuatu, so a good crowd in. Holiday Inn have put on a great spread for our entertaining guests with lots of Vanuatu water. And splash soft drinks getting consumed over there, so fantastic.
Yeah, and just to tell you again, if you're not sure where Vanuatu is, because we're only a minnow little country, we're 83 islands. We're a 2-hour flight from Brisbane east, northeast of Brisbane, and we're coronavirus free, and that's why we're able to be playing cricket and doing high fives and fist pumps. There's no social distancing here.
No.
We're good to go. This is the first day of our little tournament. We're back again Saturday in the Bet Barter.
Yeah, 10 games and two are down, two are won by the mighty Whare Panthers. And I know there's lots of interest overseas for this competition. And we really thank everyone who's getting involved with literally thousands and thousands of messages. Damo, my social media has been through the roof. Phones, I have to turn the phone off, it's just beeping all the time. And I've never had that before, don't worry about that. So it's been fantastic. I'd like to thank everyone's help out there. Bet Barter, our new supporters, putting this competition on, really. It's been fantastic
helping
from them.
The development of Vanuatu cricket.
It is. These days, you can't put a price on what playing cricket like this for us and upgrading our facility to make it look this good. Now, it's going to be a game changer for the people of Vanuatu and cricket in Vanuatu. You probably don't realise that when you're sitting in the opposite side of the world. It looks like another game of cricket. But as you say, mate, this is huge for our country. And a lot of people down there, a lot of potential sponsors and more people getting involved with cricket. So I think it's going to get bigger over the next few weeks and I can't wait for it to keep going, Damo.
Found this hybrid pitch. It's the composite turf pitch. Do you want to tell us a little bit more about the Gabba hybrid pitch?
Yeah, Gabba Grass, a company out of Brisbane, got the hybrid pitch, which is plastic synthetic grass and turf, which we shipped in from, it's called Bulleye Turf, same as what they use on the SCG. So, yeah, it gives us a spinner, probably a spin-friendly surface, which is what we need to practice on, so we don't get a chance to. We usually play on the cement carpet synthetic pitch, so this is a game changer. Guys getting practice on this, bit of pressure on the competition.
And a low cost.
At a low cost. If you can't afford a turf pitch, this is the alternative, and that's exactly what we couldn't afford a turf pitch, so we had to look for something different to give us an advantage.
Yep.
And that's what we've got, and it's great. I'm sure we're going to get probably one or two more brought over in the country, and nets as well, and it's going to change cricket for us here in Vanuatu, mate. And I can't wait to keep developing that and keep developing these opportunities that we've got.
And as we get the camera up close on us here, we can see this. We've got the Vanuatu Beverage high-tech sound boxes. Vanuatu Beverage sound, American Cola in the splash drink bottle. High-tech sound barriers for our microphones to stop the wind blowing through there.
So it's all high-tech. High-tech. It's island style. You got to work out how to do it the best as you live in the island country. It's about working out solutions to problems, Damo. That's what's living here. It's coaching the team here. We've got hardly any balls. We've got no bowling machines. We've got no this, no that. You just got to find alternative.
And appreciate all our sponsors, the Holiday Inn, the Vanuatu Beverage, the Bet Barter. Christoph Dim Construction that helps us out. It's a cracking afternoon.
Yeah, so we're going to be back Saturday again. It's going to be bigger and better. I think the guys will be better for the opportunity to play today, get the nerves out of the way, and there'll be a really good forecast too for Saturday, which is I'm very happy with.
And
we got through today, a little bit scary.
On the technical side, we will be better. We've got some high-tech stuff coming into the country tomorrow. We should be up and running much better on Saturday.
Yeah, so Andy, apologies to everyone. We've been working around the clock all night to try to get this sorted out. And we've never done anything like this before, so bear with us. Please be patient, but we'll be better next time, I assure you. And again, we'll be working around the clock non-stop for the next few days to get Saturday perfect. Then the week after, it will be just like watching Channel 9 and listening to Richie Beno back in the day, Damo.
I've had a great afternoon, mate.
Good on you, mate. Thank you, guys. And thanks, everyone, for tuning in.